Let us start our exercise 2.2. Word problem, sum number 11 to 16.
Yes, student, let us start our sum number 11. Bharat's father is 26 years younger than Bharat's grandfather and 29 years older than Bharat. The sum of the age of all the three is 135 years. What is the age of each one of them? Our dear student, here condition for Bharat's father is given. Bharat's father is 26 years younger, means he is 26 years smaller than Bharat's grandfather, and 29 years older than Bharat, means 29 years bigger than Bharat. So let us take Bharat B as a base. This is our unknown quantity. So let us suppose the age of Bharat B X. Let the age of Bharat be X year. We don't. If Bharat is X year old, what will be his father's age? His father is 29 year older than Bharat. If Bharat is X, so his father will be X plus 29. Therefore, Bharat's father age will be X plus 29 years. Here no condition for Bharat's grandfather age. But Bharat's father is 29 years younger than Bharat's grandfather. From that we can easily inculcate, if Bharat's father is 26 years younger than Bharat's grandfather, so obviously Bharat's grandfather will be 26 years bigger than Bharat's father. So let us write, and Bharat's grandfather age will be, his grandfather is, if Bharat's father is 26 years smaller than Bharat's grandfather, so obviously Bharat's grandfather will be 26 years bigger than Bharat's father. So he is 26 years bigger than Bharat's father. What is the Bharat's father age? X plus 29. So we just need to add 26 to X plus 29. This is how we got. We had supposed the age of all the three. Now we need to find the value of this X. We have to form the equation. The sum of all the three is given. The age of sum of the age of all the three is given. So let us write that only. According to the condition, or you can write as per the condition, sum of all the three, that is age of Bharat plus age of his father plus age of his grandfather, that is X plus 29 plus 26. The sum of their age is 135 years. Now what you need to do? Therefore, X, open the bracket and you will get the value. X plus X plus X will give 3X. 29 plus 29, 9 plus 9, 18, 1 carry, 2 plus 2, 4, plus 1, 5, plus 26 as it is, add it, 8 plus 6, 14, 1 carry, 5 plus 2, 7 plus 1, 84. Now here, you need to find the value of this X. So what you need to do? As I told you, transpose this value. Try to separate this value. Transpose this 84 on RHS. Write down over here. Transposing 84 to RHS. While doing such, subtract it now. That is 1, 13 minus 8. 13 minus 8 is 5. Now, either you directly bring this 3 over here and divide it 51 by 3, you will get the value of X as 70. Now we got the age of Bharat, that is he is 17 years old. So write down over here. Therefore, Bharat's age is equal to x, which is equal to 17. If Bharat is 17, what will be his father's age? Therefore, Bharat's father age, that is he is 29 years bigger than his son. If the value of x is 17, add 29 to 17, you will get 9 plus 7 is 16, 1 carry, 1 plus 2, 3 plus 1, 46 years. Now, Bharat's grandfather is 26 years bigger than Bharat's father. So, therefore, Bharat's grandfather age equals to x plus 29 plus 26. Value of x we got 17 plus 29 plus 26. Add it. This is 15, 15 plus 7, 22, 2 carry, 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1, 5, 72. That is his grandfather is 72 years. This is sum number 12. 15 years from now, Ravi's age will be 4 times his present age. What is Ravi's present age? Now dear student, here condition for Ravi's age is given and we need to find his present age. Now, after 15 years, he will be 4 times of his own present age. So let us suppose his present age be x. Let Ravi's present age be x. If Ravi's present age is x, then after 15 years, he will be 4 times of his present age. Therefore, after 15 years means, suppose his present age is x. So after 15 years, Ravi's age will be x plus 15. Means now after 15 years, he will be 4 times of his present age. Now his present age is x. So after 15 years, his age is x plus 15. And condition is given that after 15 years, he will be 4 times of his present age. So what we will do? As per the condition, now we will find the value of x. Now, what is given? 15 years from now, that is x plus 15, Ravi's age will be 4 times his present age. So, as per this condition, after 15 years, that is x plus 15, Ravi's age will be 4 times his present age. So, 4 times of his present age means, now his present age is x. So, 4 times of present age means 4x. We got a equation. See, algebraic expression on our left and constant with variable on our right. Now, dear student, here more than one variable is there, but the variables are same. So, we can solve such. It is a linear equation in one variable. Now, what we'll do? We'll try to interchange the value. Now, I will take this 4x on this side and whole value on my right. Now, you can easily solve your sum. Now what you will do, I told you, try to separate this value. So bring this x on your left. So while transposing x on your left, so it will become negative. Now here, one value constant term left. In bracket you have to write transposing x to LHS. Now Now 4x minus x gives 3x equals to 15. Either you divide both the side by 3. So that 3 and 3 will get cancelled. And 3 5's up. Here you have to write dividing both sides, both the sides by 3. Now we got the value of x, 5. That is, Ravi's present age is 5 years. So, 5 is present age. So, you can write over here in answer. Therefore, Ravi's present age is 5 years. Let's see sum number 13. A rational number is such that when you multiply it by 5 by 2 and add 2 by 3 to the product, you get negative 7 by 12. What is the number? Means, dear student, here one rational number is there, is such that when you multiply it by 7 by 2 and add 2 by 3 to the product, you will get negative 7 by 12. And we need to find that rational number. So let us first suppose that rational number be x. Let the rational number be x. Now, such that when you multiply it by 5 by 2, multiply 5 by 2 to x, which is equals to 5 by 2 into x, that is 5x by 2. Why multiply 5 by 2 to x? Because we had supposed here our rational number be x. Now, add 2 by 3 to the product. Adding 2 by 3 to, I will write this value as we already did the multiplication. We get, that is equals to, or you can write we get. What you will write? 5x by 2, you have to add 2 by 3 to it. Now, dear student, you will get negative 7 by 12. The result is therefore, the result is negative 7 by 12. Means what? Result means in this. After multiplying 5 by 2 to x and adding 2 by 3 to it, the result you are getting negative 7 by 12. This is our equation. Now, you have to solve this value. Now, dear student, as I told you, always try to separate the variable here. Variable is over here. So, what you will do? We will try to transpose the 2 by 3 on our right. Therefore, 5x by 2, negative 7 by 12, by transposing positive 2 by 3 will become negative 2 by 3. You have to write over here, transposing 2 by 3 to RHS. Now, dear student, here you need to find the LCM. LCM of 12 and 3. LCM of 12 and 3 is 12 only. If you want to find, you can find it over here. 12 and 3. 3 4s are 12. 3 1s are 3. 2 2s are 4. And 2 1s are 2. 2 3s are 6. 6 2s are 12. Therefore, LCM of 12 and 3 is 12. Now, dear student, let us solve it over here. Write down the value, whatever the value on your LHS. Write down as it is. First, we will try to solve the value on our right. After finding the LCM, try to equalize the denominator. Then only we can able to subtract the value in our numerator. So, while equalizing the denominator, your denominator should be 12. Because we found the LCM 12. So, here 12 already there. So, 12 should be multiplied by 1. Then, subtraction sign is there. 2 by 3 is there. 3 should be multiplied by what to get 12? 3 should be multiplied by 4. So whatever number you are taking in denominator, same value you have to take in numerator also. Write down this value as it is. Now negative 7 into 1, negative 7 only, 12 ones are 7, 12 ones are 12. Now 2 fours are 8, 3 fours are 12. This value as it is, minus minus plus, sign of minus only, 7 plus 8, 15 by 12. See dear student, if cancellation is possible, you cancel it. If here we can reduce the value. 3 fours are 12, 3 fives are 15, that is negative 5 by. Now dear student, finally we got negative 5 by 4 on our right. Now dear student, as I told you, always try to separate the value of x, whatever the value with x, try to reduce it. Here the 5 is in multiple form. So what I will do, if I divide this x by 5 and 2 is in division form, so I will take 2 in multiple form. So how to write this in Sudhir? What will happen? 5 and 5 will going to cancel and 2 and 2 will going to cancel. Now see dear student, write down this thing as it is. 5x by 2, and what I will do, I will multiply 2 over here and divide this value by 5. So that my 5 and 5 will get cancelled and 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So whatever value I am taking over here, same value you have to take it on your right. Then only I can cancel this value. See, 5 and 5, 2 and 2. Finally only x left. Here you have to write multiplying two by five on both these sides. Now dear student, here what is left? If it is possible to cancel 5 and 5, you can cancel it. Possible, negative 1 into 2, that is negative 2 by 4. Further, if it is possible to reduce, you can reduce it. 2 1s are and 2 2s are, so negative 1 by 2. Finally, we have got our value of x, that is our number is half, negative half. Therefore, the required number, that is the number is, that is the rational number is half. Let us see our sum number 14. Lakshmi is a cashier in a bank. She has currency note of denomination rupees 100, 50 and 10 respectively. The ratio of the number of this note is in the ratio of 2 is to 3 is to 5. The total cash with Lakshmi is rupees 4 lakh. How many notes of each denomination does she have? Now dear student, here Lakshmi is a cashier in a bank and she has rupees 4 lakh with her. It is given. Now she has a currency note of rupees 100, 50 and 10. That also given. But dear student, how many numbers of notes are there with her, it is not given. But the notes are distributed in the ratio of 2 is to 3 is to 5 is given. Now dear student, to find out the number of note, what we should do? Now see, first of all, we will suppose, let the number of rupees 100 rupee notes be 2x, because it is in the ratio of 2. Number of 50 rupees note be 3x, number of 10 rupees note be 5x. Now the total value she has 4 lakh with her. Now this 100 rupee note should be multiplied by what? So that she there should be a 4 lakh rupees with her. So that value of that 100 rupee note we need to find. Value of 100 rupees notes, that 100 should be multiplied with this 2x. We don't know that number of coin, and that number of coin is multiplied by 2 and multiplied by 100, so that we will get the value of this 100 rupee note, that is 200x. Value of rupees 50 note, that is 50 rupees multiplied by 3x, so you will get 150x. Value of rupees 10, that is 10 into 5x, that is 50x. Now these are the value, these dear student, these are the values. means this many number of 100 rupee, this many number of 50 rupee, and this many number of 10 rupee should be there, then only your value should be 4 lakh rupee. Now, as per the given condition, she has 4 lakh rupee with her. So, what we'll do, as per the given condition, she has 4 lakh rupees. So, she has, we don't know, 200 times of x of 100 rupee note, 150 times of 50 rupee note, and 50 times of x of 10 rupee note, and all gives 4 lakh rupees. Sum of all gives 4 lakh rupee. Now, dear student, you just need to add the value, that is 200 plus 150, 350 plus 50, 400x. Now, dear student, either you take this 400 over here or divide both the side by 400 so that you can easily get the value of this x. You have to write the statement over here, dividing both these sides by 400. So that this 400 will go, going to cancel, and 0, 0 going to cancel. Therefore, the value of x will be 4,000 divided by 4 will be 1,000. That means we got the value of x over here. That is what? Now we need to find the how many notes of each denomination she have. Means the number of note. Means therefore, number of 100 rupee note. Numbers of 100 rupees note. Very simple. You just need to multiply. That is 2x. 2 you have to multiply with 1000 because we got the value of x as 1000. Means 2000 note of 100 rupees. Numbers of 50 rupees note. That is 3x. 3 into 1000 gives 3000 notes. That means there are 3000 notes of 50 rupees. Numbers of rupees 10, 10 rupee note, that is 5x equals to 5 multiplied by 1000, 5000 notes. That means what, dear student, there are 2000 note of 100 rupees, 3000 note of 50 rupees, and 5000 note of 10 rupees are there. When you will make a sum of all, you will get 4 lakh rupees. When you will make a sum, means when we will multiply this 2000 with 100, you will get 2 lakh. When we will multiply this 3000 with 50, you will get 1,50,000. When we will multiply this 5000 with 10, you will get 50,000. When we will add, and you will get the total 4 lakh. Let us say sum number 15. I have a total of rupees 300. In coins of denomination rupees 1, rupees 2 and rupees 5, the number of 2 rupees coin is 3 times the number of 5 rupee coin. The total numbers of coins is 160. How many coins of each denomination are with me? Now, dear student, here in all I have rupees 300 with me. Now, in the 300, I have 1 rupee, 2 rupee and 5 rupees coin with me. Now, dear student, I don't know how many number of 1 rupee coin, 2 rupee coin and 5 rupee coin. That I have to find. It is exactly similar to that previous sum, just now whatever we did. Now, dear student, in that previous case, the number of denominator were divided in the ratio of 2:3:5. But here, no such ratios are given. But the condition for it given. See, here, 2 rupee coin is 3 times the 5 rupee coin. So what we will do? We have to do, we have to suppose let the number of 5 rupee coin be x, so that we can easily find the number, how many number of 2 rupee coins are there. Let the numbers of 5 rupee coins be x. If number of 5 rupee coins is x, therefore the numbers of 2 rupee coins will be, it is 2 rupee coin is 3 times the 5 rupee coin. If the number of 5 rupee coin is x, the number of 2 rupee coin will be 3 times of x, that is 3x. You can write it over here, equals to 3x. Now we got number of 5 rupee coin, that is x, number of 2 rupee coin, that is 3x. What about number of 1 rupee coin? No such condition is given, but here total number of coin, that is 160, is given. From that we have to subtract number of 5 rupee coin and number of 2 rupee coin, and numbers of 1 rupee coins. What you need to do is 160, that is total number of coin, minus 2 rupee coin, that is number of 2 rupee coin, that is 3x, and x, that is number of 5 rupee coin. So 160, this you have to add, 3x minus 3x minus x is minus 4x. So we got this many numbers of 1 rupee coin, this many number of 2 rupee coin, and this many number of 5 rupee coins are there. Now, dear student, now the value you need to find. Now, the value of 5 rupees coin, 5 rupee coin. That is, you need to multiply 5 with number of 5 rupee coin, that is 5x. Value of 2 rupees coin, that is equal to, you have to multiply 2 with, that is number of 2 rupee coin is 3x, that is 6x. And value of 1 rupees coin, that is 1 multiply by this many numbers of 1 rupee coin. When you multiply with 1, same value you will get. Why we need to find the value? Because we have to equalize all this value with the amount which is given, the value with me. You have to equalize. Now, as per the given condition, total of 300 rupees. So, total means I have to make a sum of all this value. That is 5x plus 6x plus 160 minus 4x gives 300 rupees. Sum of all the, I don't know, number of 5 rupee coin, number of 2 rupee coin, number of 1 rupee coin, I don't know how many number of coins are there. So, sum of all value gives 300 rupees. Therefore, 5x plus 6x is 11x minus 4x. 160, 11x minus 4x gives 7x. Take this 160, transpose it, you have to write it, transposing 160 to RHS, we are transposing 160 to RHS, that is, now when you subtract you will get 140. When you will divide 140 by 7, or you can divide both the side by 7, or directly you can do transposition. So you will get the value of x as 20. Now here we got the value 20. Now we can easily find the how many coins of each denomination are with me. So what I will do, one by one, I will try to find numbers of 5 rupees coin. That I just need to, that is, which is equals to x, which is equals to 20. 20 numbers of 5 rupees coin. Numbers of 2 rupees coin. 2 is, that is 3 times x. That is 3 into value of x, I got 20. That is 60 coins of 2 rupees. And number of 1 rupees coin. 1 rupees coin, that is given 160 minus 4x 160 minus 4, value of x is 20, that is 160. 420 is 80. 160 minus 80 is 80 rupees, 80 coins. Now, dear student, see, 20 coins of 5 rupees, 60 coins of 2 rupees, and 80 coins of 1 rupees are there. Total in all, if you add 20 plus 60 is 80, and 80 and 80, 160, we got the value, that is number of coin, it is tally. Now, if you want to check your amount, see, 20, that is 20 coins of 5, that is 100 rupees, 60 coins of 2 rupees, that is 120 rupees, and 80 coins of 1 rupees, that is 80 only. When you will add the value, you will get 300 rupees. Let us see sum number 16. The organizer of an essay competition decide that a winner in the competition gets a prize of rupees 100 and a participant who does not win get a prize of rupees 25. The total prize money distributed is rupees 3000. Find the number of winners if the total number of participants is 63. Now, dear student, here, how many number of participants who win the competition and the number of participants who are non-winner are not given. So, let us first suppose, let the number of participant who wins the essay competition, that is winner be x. Let us suppose it as a x. Now, we don't know the number of participant who wins. So, let the number of winners be x. We don't know. So, therefore, the number of participant who does not win means who are non-winner. If number of winners is x, what will be the number of non-winner? From this we will find total number of participant is 63. So if number of winner is x, the number of non-winner will be 63 minus x. Now, dear student, here it is given that the winner in the competition will get a prize of rupees 100. So what we will write? Winner should get rupees 100. That is, you have to multiply, we don't know the number of winner, we had supposed it as x, that is 100 into x give 100x, and participant who does not win get rupees 25. So therefore, non-winner will get rupees 25, that is 25 multiplied by how many numbers of non-winners are there? We don't know, that is 63 minus x. You have to multiply this. So how to multiply? Very simple. 25 into 63 minus 25 into x. So 25 into 63, how you will multiply? Don't go with this method. Go with this method. Split this 25 into 20 plus 5. So that you can easily do the multiplication. See, now 63 should be multiplied by 20 and 63 should be multiplied by 5. You can orally do such multiplication. So 63, very simple, 63 20 sum is, you have to multiply by 2. 2 3s are 6 and 2 6 are 12 and 1 0. Then multiply 63 with 5. 5 3s are 15. 1 carry, 6 5s are 30, 31. Now add it, 5 plus 0, 5, 6 plus 1, 7, 2 plus 3, 5 and 1. That is 1575 minus 25 into x, 25x. Now, dear student, we got this many winner. We'll get 100 times the x. We don't know the number of winner and we don't know the number of non-winner. Now, this many value they will get. Now, total amount of amount distribution is given 3000 rupees. So, what we will write as per the given condition. That is, they get the total amount distributed is rupees 3000. So, what we will do, total sum, that is 100 times x. 100 times x means winner will get rupees 100 and 1575 minus 25x will get non-winner. Non-winner will get this amount and total price distribution is rupees 3000. Now, from here you know it's very simple. 100x minus 25x gives 75x. Now transpose this value on your right. Right on over here, transposing 1575 to RHS. Now dear student, 75 now subtract it. It's very simple. 1425. Now how to either you divide both the side by 75 or take the 75 below 1425. Now division very simple. 1425 divides by 7. 75 2s are 150, not possible, so put 0. 75 1s are 75, subtract it, 7, 67. 75 9s are 9. Therefore, we got the value of x, 19. 19 we got. Now, dear student, there are 19 numbers of winners are there. The number of winner that is equals to x, which is equals to 19, and number of non-winner it is not asked, but then also we'll find number of non-winner. How many non-winners are there? That is 63. That is 63 minus x, 63 minus 19 gives 63. Subtract it, 63 minus 19. Are non-winners.